Yahweh, to be happy in Jesus, better trust and obey. Not a body we bear, not a sorrow we share, but a toy doth richly repay. Not a grief, nor a loss, nor a frown, nor a cross, but he bless if we trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus, but to trust and obey. But we never can prove that the light of his love or the other altar we lay. For the favor he showed and the joy he bestowed are for them who we trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus, but to trust and obey. Then in fellowship sweet, we will sit at his feet, or we walk by his side in thy way. Where he says we will go, where he leads we will go. Never fear, only trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus than to trust and obey. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. If you want to be happy in Jesus, you have to trust him and obey him. Brethren, to obey is better than sacrifice, to hearken than the fat of ram. What God demands from us at this end time is to obey him, beloved brethren. Obey the word of God. Believe the word of God. Do the word of God. May God give us the grace to run this race perfectly in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. You are all welcome to today's Bible study. Please kindly invite your friends, your neighbors, your husband, your wife, your children. Gather them together. Tell them it is time for us now to study the word of God. You just have your Bible and your paper to write. If there's any question, we will open the line as time goes on that you can ask your question. Even though the question is not from what we are going to study, you can ask also. We'll be able to put light, because iron sharpened iron. It is not the will of God for any man to perish, brethren. He wants us to trust him and obey him. May God give us the grace in the mighty name of Jesus. We are going to pray. Please, if you are a woman, kindly cover your hair as we are going to pray. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you, we bless your name for the opportunity given to us to study your word today. Lord, we thank you for the day you have made, O Lord God. We are happy. We thank you for making it possible for us to be among the living. Many are dead before now, but your grace was sufficient for us, O God. Be thou exalted, Lord, and glorified. All we are going to be doing this hour, let your will be done. Let your glory be seen. Every powers of the enemy that hinders people from hearing the word of God, I bind your powers and your precious. Be bound in heaven in the mighty name of Jesus. I cover this studio alive All the instruments we'll be using are soaked up with the blood of Jesus. The viewers are soaked with the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Father, that the end of the name of the Lord will be exalted. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. You are all welcome once again. In the mighty name of Jesus, I want to bless you for the contribution, the question. If the answer given is not enough, you can still ask. If you are not satisfied, you need to ask again. Don't be ashamed, beloved brethren. Whatsoever that is bothering you, you can ask. We're going to put light into it. Hallelujah. Today, we are going to be studying a very interesting topic. So please take your Bible and write. We'll be talking about spiritual warfare. Spiritual warfare. If you don't know the finishing work of Christ, you have to go back to my page and listen to the finished work of Christ that we have studied. You must be able to know what Jesus has come to do. Praise the Lord. If you don't know that, you can't be able to cope with what we are going to study. You have to go back when you have time, go through the finished work of Christ. Because Jesus came, he said, it is finished. Hallelujah. Your trouble, your anxiety, your worries, your sorrow, he said, all is over. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. So we'll be talking about spiritual warfare. Beloved brethren, we are in a battle with the enemy. But I know if you go to any battle with the Lord Jesus, you will be a winner. Hallelujah. Amen. Before we start to read the word of God, I want to make us understand that there are differences between the life of Jesus and the one the prophets of old lived. For example, the Bible says in Exodus 22 verses 18, let us start from there. Exodus 22 verses 18. There are many things that were permitted in the old time that is not permitted at this time. Hallelujah. You must be able to know. Exodus 22 verses 18. Please have your Bible. Let us read together. Thou shalt not suffer a witch to live. That is what the Bible says in Exodus 22 verse 18. So you must understand that before Jesus came, they were killing witches and wizards. Hallelujah. And when Jesus came, he didn't mention anything witch or wizard at all. Praise the Lord. So you must be able to know the spirit of Jesus and the spirit that was of old. Hallelujah. So the time that we are, we must possess the spirit of Jesus. Otherwise, we'll be making mistakes. The race that we are, brethren, is a narrow road. The Bible says many are called, but few are going to be chosen. There is a rule, regulation. If you want to go to heaven, you must be able to walk like Jesus did, like the apostles did. Otherwise, you will make mistakes. Hallelujah. You must understand that there is no excuse on that day. Jesus is coming for a glorious church without spot or wrinkle. We are talking about spiritual warfare. How do we handle this warfare? It's different from the one that they were handling before Jesus came. Praise the Lord. So we must be able to know The life of Jesus is the life we must live. The life of the apostles is the life that we must live. Many native doctors, they have Bible, Holy Bible, in their shrine. They operate on the law of Moses that says an eye for an eye. This is where they stand to invoke evil on people. So we must understand that not only Christians are carrying the Bible. Native doctors, they carry the Bible also. But when they want to operate, they go to the law of Moses. So we, in the time of Christ, we must possess the spirit of Jesus. Hallelujah. Because most of the things are not permitted at this time. We don't kill anybody. If somebody is in your family, they say this person is a witch or wizard, you don't have right to kill that person physically like they were doing of old. No, you cannot. Praise the Lord. There are some Bible verses that would go into, like Proverbs 26:27. Let us quickly go there quickly. We are talking about spiritual warfare. If you don't understand this, you can't be able to flow with what you are going to study. Proverbs 26:27. It says, "Whoso diggeth a pit shall fall therein, and he that rolleth a stone, it will be rolled upon him." It is in the Bible, but we don't use it anymore. We don't say it to anybody. Whosoever dig a pit will fall into it. No, that is not the language of Jesus. That is not the language of the apostles. If you look at the way the apostles walk, they walk at the footstep of Jesus. If you must enter heaven, you must walk in the footstep of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. If you are still using this place to curse people, Whosoever dig a pit for me, you fall into it. You are wrong. You should repent. That is not the prayer of Jesus. This was done before Jesus came. Praise the Lord. I want to open our eyes because most people are living in ignorance. And that is not an excuse. Hallelujah. My pastor is doing it. Doesn't mean it is right. Look at your Bible. Here is the gathering of the heavenly candidate in true holiness. Even in holiness, most of them have been defiled. Hallelujah. In true holiness and righteousness, according to the life of Jesus, that is what we are talking about. Not how my pastor is doing it, not how you were taught. Everybody are doing it, doesn't make it right. We are talking about spiritual warfare. Because the way many people are talking about culture deliverance, if we are preaching repentance, it will be more profitable today. Hallelujah. The message is repent. Give your life to Jesus and live a holy life. Glory be to God. Amen. Repentance is the message that we need to preach and teach at this time. Serving God in spirit and in truth. Holiness and righteousness, beloved brethren. Amen. So before Jesus came, people used this. Whosoever dig a pit for me shall fall into it. Now, these days, you don't use that anymore. That is the difference. The spirit of Jesus did not accommodate this as it was before. We must understand that we are followers of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. Also in Matthew chapter 5, let us go to 38 quickly. We'll be talking about spiritual warfare, but before we go in, you must understand what you are doing. Matthew 5, 38 to 48. Matthew chapter 5. Do you want to see Jesus on the last day? You must be the doers of the word of God. You must be a follower of Jesus Christ in holiness and righteousness. You must drop every idea that you know. Even though you were taught when you were very young, drop them. You must follow Jesus. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. He said, no man that cometh unto the Father except by him. Matthew 5, 38. Ye have heard that it has been said, an eye for an eye, and a tooth for a tooth. But I say unto you, that ye resist not evil, but whosoever shall smite thee on the right cheek, turn to him the other also. And if any man will sue thee in the law, and take away thy coat, let him have thy cloak also. And whosoever shall compel thee to go a mile, go with him twain. Give to him that ask thee, and him that will borrow, turn not away. Ye have heard that it has been said, thou shalt love thy neighbor and hate thy enemy. But I say unto you, love your enemy. Bless them that curse you. Do good to them that hate you. And pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you, that ye may be children of your Father which is in heaven. For he maketh his sun to rise on the evil and on the good, and sendeth rain on the just and on the just. For if you love them which love you, what reward have ye? Do not even the publican the same. And if you salute your brethren, what do ye more than others? Do not even the publican so? 48. Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father which is in heaven is perfect. Most of the time, the word of God is bitter, beloved brethren, but you have to swallow it. You have to obey if you want to see Jesus on the last day. Because only true believers will be raptured. Hallelujah. This is what the Bible says. Before Jesus came, if you blind my eye, I have the right to blind your eye. Eye for an eye. That is back to the sender that people are saying today. Hallelujah. An eye for an eye. When you are still praying a prayer of back to the sender, you are doing an eye for an eye. And you are living in ignorance. You have not yet possessed the spirit of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory be to God. So you must understand that before Jesus came, most of these things were being used. And it was allowed. But Jesus has come. He is the way, he is the truth, and he is the life. Glory be to God. So we must follow Jesus because he is our peace. We must follow the ways of the apostles. Whatsoever you don't see the apostle doing, whatsoever you did not see Jesus doing, if you are doing it, you are on your own. Hallelujah. Amen. If you are doing them, you are on your own. Therefore, we must follow the step of Jesus. If we know, we want to see Jesus on the last day. Beloved brethren, he's coming for a glorious church without spot or wrinkle. I don't know whether you are prepared. We are talking about spiritual warfare. Before Jesus came, the law of an eye for an eye was in operation. He has come now to let us know that we don't need to revenge. If you are still revenging, because the Bible says vengeance belongs to God, then you are living in ignorance. Amen. then you don't have the spirit of Christ. Praise the Lord. Now, before Jesus came, beloved brethren, if you read 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 40, the Bible says Elijah slew the prophet of Baal. But at this time, you don't have right to kill anybody. Elijah slew the prophet of Baal. But now Jesus has come to show us the way that we must forgive and we must not revenge. There is nothing like an eye for an eye. No, it is wrong. There is nothing like bow to the sender. No, it is wrong. If you must see Jesus, you must have the Spirit of Christ in you. Hallelujah. Romans chapter 8, verses 9. Spiritual warfare. Hallelujah. We are in a battle. That is why Paul said we are soldiers. We have to be at alert. Most people are fighting as one beating the air because you are not obeying Jesus, because you are not doing what Jesus asked us to do. Most people are not following the steps of the apostle. We must stop where Jesus stopped, where the apostle stopped. You must not add or take away. You must understand the spirit of Jesus. Hallelujah. Romans 8 verse 9. Please, if you have your Bible, please put down your question if you have any that you are going to ask, because this is worldwide Bible study. Here is the gathering of the heavenly candidates in true holiness and righteousness. Those who prepare, those who said, I will forgive those that have offended me, those who will ask forgiveness from others, those who are sanctified, those who are prepared for the master's use. Hallelujah. Romans 8 verse 9. It says, but ye are not in the flesh, but in the spirit. If so be that the spirit of God dwell in you. Now, if any man have not the spirit of Christ, he is not of his. If any man, any woman does not have the spirit of Jesus, you are not of his. You may be a preacher, you may be an apostle, you may be an evangelist, you may be a prophet, prophetess. If you don't have the spirit of Jesus, you are not of his. That is why you must understand that the spirit of Jesus is different from the way Elijah and Elisha operated. Hallelujah. Elijah slew the prophet of Baal. Elijah called down fire to consume the soldiers that were sent. But Jesus is not permitting us to do this. That is the difference. You must understand this. If you don't understand, you'll be living in ignorance. Forget about what your pastor is saying. But we have to look at what the Bible is saying. What is the word of God saying concerning any situation? There is nothing like back to the sender. Not at all. There's nothing for an eye for an eye. No. There's nothing like die by fire or thunder. Not at all. It's not the life of Jesus. Hallelujah. In John chapter 10, verse 10, the Bible says, the thief cometh not, but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. Jesus said, I have come that you may have life and have it more abundantly. I said it before, the way we are calling for people to come to deliverance, if we are preaching holiness and righteousness, if we are preaching repentance, it will be more profitable. Amen. The message of Jesus is repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent from your sin. Repent from your evil way. That is the message. Praise the Lord. If you look at the Bible, You will see where Apostle Paul will say he's a deliverance minister. No, he didn't call himself that. The power of God was sufficient for him. The Bible said that even handkerchief was taken from his body to heal the sick. He didn't call himself that he's a deliverance minister. We are trying to put people in bondage, calling ourselves deliverance minister. It's not biblical. Hallelujah. If you must drop your pride, if you want to go to heaven, put your pride down, your arrogancy. Drop whatever you think you know and follow the word of God. Hallelujah. Follow the word of God. Most people are dwelling upon, this is how my pastor is doing it. No, no, no. How is Jesus doing it? How did the apostle live the life of Christ? That is your standard. Hallelujah. Amen. That is your standard. In 2 Kings chapter 2, verses 23, quickly, open your Bible. Spiritual warfare. You must understand this as we go into that. You must understand who you are, which spirit is possessing you. Many people are singing, God of Elijah, send a fire. God of Elijah, send a fire. You are singing in vain because Jesus did not send any fire when he came. It's ignorance. Hallelujah. You must understand who you are in Christ Jesus. You may be a prophet or prophetess and still living in ignorance. Hallelujah. In 2 Kings chapter 2, let's go there quickly. Verse 23 to 24. 2 Kings chapter 2, 23 to 24. And he went up from there unto Bethel. As he was going by the way, there came four little children out of the city. He's talking about Elisha. And mocked him and said unto him, go ye, thou bareheaded. Go up, thou bareheaded. And he turned back and looked on them and cursed them in the name of the Lord. And there came forth two she-bears out of the wood and tore 42 children of them. We don't do that this time. We don't kill. We don't curse. Thou shall not curse. This spirit that Elisha and Elijah was operating upon, that is not what Jesus came for. Hallelujah. Some of you may be wondering, what is pastor talking about? I'm telling you that the spirit of Christ is what we're supposed to possess. Not the spirit of die by fire, by thunder. Not the spirit of go back to the center. No, you are living in ignorance. Drop those ideas and follow Jesus. He is the way, the truth, and the life. Many holiness preachers have wandered away. May God restore as many as have fallen in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. The Spirit of Christ must possess you. Elisha looked at these children because they were mocking him. He sent beer to tear them up. He caused them. This time we don't do that, beloved brethren. The Spirit of Jesus must possess you. Otherwise, you will see him on that day. Where Wurre said, if any man have not the Spirit of Christ, is not of his. Many people are preaching. You can speak in tongue. You can prophesy. You can heal the sick. You can raise the dead. But not having the Spirit of Jesus in you still, you will not see Jesus on that day. If any man, anyone at all, have not the Spirit of Christ, is not of his. The Spirit of Jesus is different from the way Elisha operated. Hallelujah. Until you know this, you cannot be able. The thief cometh not, but to kill, to steal, and to destroy. Jesus said, I have come that you may have life, not death. Not just having it, brethren, having it more abundantly. You must know the finishing work of Christ. You must know what Jesus has come to do if you must see Jesus at this end time. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. The footsteps of the apostles is what we must follow. Most of the things Elijah and Elisha did, it was permitted before Jesus came. But this time around, it is not. You don't send fire to anyone. You don't ask anyone to fall into the hole, whether a dig hole or not. We are in the time to pray for our enemy. Bless them that curse you. Hallelujah. The spirit of Jesus is different from the spirit of Elijah and Elisha. Jesus has come to show us the way, beloved brethren. You have heard in the only time that an eye for an eye. But I am telling you, Jesus said, if anyone smack you on the right hand, give the left. You want to go to heaven? It's not an easy road, beloved brethren. Hallelujah. It's not an easy road. The road is a narrow road. It's not wide. You can't do what you want to do and expect to see Jesus. No. He said, I will say to many at that day, depart, I know you not. He that walks in iniquity, may that not be your portion. For that not to be your portion, you must repent now. You must turn away from those ideas that you have borrowed from your pastor. Don't let your pastor lead you to hell, beloved brethren. Don't let your apostle lead you to hell. Thou shalt not curse. That is what the Bible says. Bless them that curse you. If you are not doing this, you are not having the spirit of Christ. Praise the Lord. The spirit of Jesus is gentle. The spirit of Jesus is not to kill. It's not to destroy. The spirit of Jesus is kind. Praise the Lord. Going to heaven is not easy. Many are called. Few are going to be chosen. That is why you must forgive those that offended you. It is a must. You must ask forgiveness from those whom you have offended, whether big or small. Put down your pride and ask them to forgive you. As many as you have offended, go and meet them. Tell them to forgive you. Tell them to forgive you. You must do your restitution completely. Whatever that does not belong to you, you must give it to the owner. If you must go to heaven, whosoever you have cheated, you must go and amend whatever you have taken. Even though you have built a house on somebody's land, you must return the land back to the owner. Otherwise, you are not prepared for heaven at all. May you not labor in vain. Pastors, apostles, bishop, prophet, prophetess, it is time for us to come back to Jesus in true holiness and righteousness. Stop deceiving the members that Jesus died for. Hallelujah. Stop leading them astray. We must forgive those that offended us. Forgiveness is what Jesus said. Not anyone to die. It's not the will of God that any man should perish, but to have life. That is why we are still alive today, beloved brethren, so that we can repent, genuine repentance, if we must see Jesus. We are talking about spiritual warfare. So I'm preparing our mind for us to know who we are. The spirit that must possess you must be the spirit of Jesus. If you are not operating like Jesus did, like the apostle did, you have missed it and you are on your own. That is why we have looked at the Bible Elijah called that fire to kill people, to destroy the army. Elisha called the children, they be aged up. Jesus has not come to do any of these things. Hallelujah. Jesus has come to let us know what is forgiveness, repentance, genuine repentance. That is what we're supposed to have. Praise the Lord. So the spirit of Jesus has not come to kill anybody, beloved brethren. That is the spirit that you must possess. Let us look at Luke chapter 9. If you don't have the spirit of Jesus, you are not of his. From 51, Luke chapter 9. You may be an apostle, bishop, prophet, pope. And if you don't have the spirit of Jesus, you are not of him. If you are not operating the way Jesus did, you are not of him. If all you know is die by fire, by thunder, return back to sender, you cannot see Jesus on that day. That is not the spirit of Jesus. Going to heaven is not easy, beloved brethren. The road is a narrow road. You can't do what you want to do and expect to see Jesus on that day. You will not. Luke chapter 9 from 51. He says, and it came to pass when the time was come that he would have received up, he steadfastly set his face to go to Jerusalem and sent messenger before his face. And they went and entered into a village of a Samaritan to make ready for him. 53. And they did not receive him because his face was as though he would go to Jerusalem. And when his disciples James and John saw this, they said, Lord, we doubt that we command fire to come down from heaven and consume them, even as Elijah did. But he turned and rebuked them and said, ye know not what manner of spirit ye are of. This is the difference. There's a difference between the spirit of Jesus and the spirit of Elijah and Elisha. Hallelujah. You still say God of Elijah, send that fire, you are living in ignorance. That is not the spirit that Jesus came with. For the Son of Man is not come to destroy man's life, but to save them. And they went another village. Do you want to see Jesus on the last day? Only true believers shall be raptured. Only those that obey the Bible. Drop your education. Drop your PhD. Drop your whatsoever level you have in theology. Put them aside. It is the spirit that quickeneth. The flesh profited nothing. The Bible makes us to understand that when they look at Peter and the brethren, they understand that these people were not learned, but they knew that they have been with Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. They knew that they have been with what? With Jesus. Glory be to God. If you don't have the spirit of Jesus, you are not of his. The disciples said, Master, because these people refuse to allow us to do what we want to do, let us send fire. Most of your prayer is die by fire, die by fire, die by fire. It is ignorance. It is not the spirit of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Despite you call fire and fire come down, doesn't mean that the spirit of Jesus. Native daughter called fire and fire come down also. It is not the spirit of Jesus at all. The spirit of Jesus is different entirely. Hallelujah. Amen. We must follow the steps of Jesus. Otherwise, we will not see him on the last day. Going to heaven is not easy, beloved brethren. You must obey the word of God. You must obey the word of God. Praise the Lord. You know, most people, they thought that until you said that by fire, that prayer will not work. No, it is not. That is not what makes prayer to work. And if you look at the prayer of Jesus that he taught his disciple, there's nothing like that by fire there. You can't hear that from Apostle Paul. You can't hear that from Apostle Peter. None of the apostles. Men are deceived. Women are deceived. May you not go to hell with your pastor. There are many pastors who don't want to repent. They know that what they are teaching is wrong, but they are ashamed to come out and repent. It is better you come out and repent than go to hell, because hell is not prepared for mankind. The word of God is bitter, brethren, but that is the truth. That is why when Jesus is speaking, people don't want to listen. People, they're always annoyed. And most of the time, they try to leave. Jesus looked at them, he said, Peter, your people are going, can't you go? Here, we are not here to make you jump up and down. Here is to prepare you for the coming of the Lord in true holiness and righteousness, serving God in spirit and in truth. Not how your pastor is teaching you, but what is the word of God saying? You have the Bible with you. You can ask your pastor questions. Any man of God that's not leading you right, leave that place. Because your life is important, beloved brethren. Jesus died for you. Hallelujah. Amen. Jesus said, you don't know the manner of spirit you are. That is to let you know that the manner of the spirit that Jesus came with is different from the one Elisha operated upon. Because Elijah and Elisha was violent one. Kill, die was the spirit. But Jesus said, bless, forgive. That is the two difference. And many preachers are still operating on that spirit of Elijah and Elisha. Kill them. Kill them before they kill me. These are spirit of Elijah. It is not of Jesus. Hallelujah. If you are a true follower of Jesus Christ, nobody can harm you. Amen. That is what a believer must understand. If you are genuinely born again, nobody can harm you. No weapon formed and fashioned against you that shall prosper. If you are genuinely born again. Men of God are creating fear in you. Bring water, you rush. Bring candle, you rush. Bring oil, you rush. Because you don't know your left from your right. Spiritual warfare, beloved brethren. Repent is what John has come to teach. Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent. If you genuinely repent from your evil, beloved brethren, nothing. Because you are covered as a child of God 24 hours. What will make you not to be covered is sin. So don't be afraid. Hallelujah. If it is my mother died, if it is my father died, my sister died, my brother died, that is ignorance prayer. It is not of Jesus. It is time for us to repent. We are talking about spiritual warfare. If you don't know this, if you don't know the difference between the spirit of Jesus and the spirit of Elijah and Elisha, you'll be making mistakes. Jesus said to them, you don't know the manner of spirit that is in you. It is not that to kill, to send that fire. He rebuked them. He said, stop. Stop. Praise the Lord. Going to heaven is not easy. Only few will be able to make it on that day. May God make you to be one of the few in the mighty name of Jesus. The word of God is bitter when the truth is said, beloved brethren. I pray, may you have the spirit of Jesus in the mighty name of Jesus. You can put down your question and you can ask. Here is the gathering of the heavenly candidate in true holiness and righteousness. Do you want to see Jesus on the last day? You must obey the Bible, the word of God. You must not add to it or take away from it. You must be able to operate on the spirit of Jesus, the way the apostles operated. If not, you are on your own. Hallelujah. Amen. Let us look at the life of Brother Stephen. This is one of the spirits of Jesus. Acts of Apostles chapter 7. Hallelujah. Please, Acts of Apostles chapter 7 quickly. 55. Acts of Apostles chapter 7 from 55. Let us see what the Bible is saying. Amen. Acts of Apostles chapter 7 from 55 down to 60. He says, and said, behold, I see heaven open, and the Son of Man standing on the right hand of God. Then they cried out with a loud voice and stopped their ears and ran upon him with one accord and cast him out of the city and stole him. And the witness laid down their clothes at the young man's feet, whose name was Saul. And they stoned Stephen, calling upon God and saying, Lord Jesus, receive my spirit. Lord Jesus, receive my spirit. And he knelt down and cried with a loud voice, Lord, lay not this sin on their charge. And when he had said this, he fell asleep. Lord, lay not this on their charge. He didn't say by fire, go to fire, die by fire. No. He said, Lord, forgive them. Do not require this sin from them. That is the spirit of Jesus Christ at this time. If you must see Jesus, you must possess the spirit of Jesus. Spiritual warfare. The spirit of Jesus is different from the spirit that Elisha operated. Where men of God still stand on the people that be cursed today, thou shalt not curse. Heaven is not easy. Many are called, but few are going to be chosen. If you must be among the chosen, you must walk according to the footstep of Jesus, according to the footstep of the apostles of old. Hallelujah. You must possess the spirit of Jesus. If anyone have not the spirit of Jesus, it's not of him. Spirit of die by thunder, by fire, by brimstone, by caterpillar, is not of Jesus. Hallelujah. No, an eye for an eye is not for the spirit of Jesus. Jesus said, forgive. We see the life of our brother Stephen when he was being stoned. He said, Father, forgive them. Do not lay it at their charge. Are you a child of God? Can you be able to operate on these footsteps? These are the steps that Jesus took when he came. Praise the Lord. Going to heaven is not easy. Many are called, but few are going to enter. There is a road that is very wide. Broadway. The Bible says many are those that find that road. They are trooping in. Praise the Lord. But the road going to heaven is narrow. That is why you must be careful. You must obey the word of God. Stop what you know. Stop your PhD. Drop anything you have in your theology and have the spirit of Jesus with you. Operate like Jesus operated. Operate like the apostles operated. Hallelujah. Otherwise, you will not see Jesus on the last day. This is an example of the spirit of Jesus. When they were stoning Stephen, he said, forgive them, for they know not what they did. But when Elisha was mocked, Elisha called Beer to destroy the children. When soldiers were sent to arrest Elijah, Elijah called out fire to destroy them. The prophet of Baal, Elijah slayed them. Jesus has not come with that spirit. He said, you don't know the manner of spirit that you are of. Many Christians are trooping to hell because of ignorance. You may be an apostle, it doesn't matter. You may be a bishop, it doesn't matter. A pope, any position you may be occupying, put down your pride and return back to Jesus. Repent in holiness and righteousness, in spirit and in truth. If you know, you must see Jesus on that day. There is a difference between the spirit of Jesus and the spirit that was being in oppression before he came. He said, forgive them that offended you. The law of an eye for an eye is no more in operation. When you are still praying, return back to sender. Die by fire. Die by thunder. That is eye for an eye. Jesus has not come with that spirit. You are living in ignorance. Hallelujah. Going to heaven is not easy. Your position will not carry you down there unless you trust and obey. You know, when they came to arrest Jesus, one of the disciples smote the ear of those that came. But Jesus took it back and put it back. That is the spirit of Jesus. That is the spirit of Jesus. You are still praying, those that dig hole for me, let them fall into it. You are ignorance. That is not spirit of Jesus. Your prayer is, oh God, open their eyes for them to repent. Do you want to see Jesus on that day? It doesn't matter what your pastor have taught you. It doesn't matter what your bishop have taught you. The spirit of Jesus is what you must possess. If you know, you must see him on that day. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Luke chapter 23, verses 34. We are working on spiritual warfare. You must know this basis as we are going to be going to this topic, because it will take us some time. You must know who you are. You must know the difference between the spirit of Jesus and vengeance spirit. Praise the Lord. Luke chapter 23, quickly. Please put down your question. Here you are allowed to ask your question and you will get your answer. It's worldwide Bible study. You are in Africa, you are in Asia, America, Canada, Australia, wherever you are, Europe. Put down your question, ask, and we'll be able to answer your question. Glory be to God. Luke 23, verses 34. They said, Jesus, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And they parted his ramlet and cast it. Father, forgive them. That is the spirit of Jesus. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Your pastor is putting you into bondage, telling you that people will kill you. That is why you are praying such violent, die by fire, die by thunder, die by bristol, because you are ignorance, and your pastor is also ignorance. Don't follow such pastor to hell. Hallelujah. Don't follow them to hell. The Bible is before you. Before Jesus came, you are allowed to kill an eye for an eye. You blind my eye, I blind your eye. But when Jesus came, he said, no. If somebody slap you in the right hand, give the person the left one. Do you want to see Jesus? Hallelujah. Stephen said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Do not lay this charge against them. Are you ready to forgive those who have offended you? You say, Pastor, you don't know what they have done to me. No matter what, you are to forgive if you want to go to heaven. Hallelujah. Many people are on the road, doesn't mean it's right. There is a way that seems right to a man, the end thereof is destruction, ignorance. Die by fire, die by thunder, die by bristol. You dig a hole for me, you enter. These are not prayer of Jesus. You must understand that. That is not the spirit of Jesus that you are operating on. Jesus said to the disciple, said, let us send down fire. He said, no, you don't know the manner of spirit you are of. It is not the spirit of send down fire anymore. Praise the Lord. You say, Pastor, I'm saying it is working for me. Native daughter say it also, and it worked for them. Native daughter have Bible in their stride. You are not different from them until you put away your pride and repent. You can't see Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. People used to say, from the days of John the Baptist, kingdom of God so violent. They don't understand what that scripture means. Right from the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God survived violence. Many people don't know what it means. Your pastor is quoting it without understanding. Let us quickly look at that before we close tonight. Amen. Let us quickly see that. Then we'll be closing. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's see Mark chapter 6. Mark 6, 14. Quickly. We are going to close. Mark 6, 14. Let us look at what the Bible is saying. Because if you don't know the Bible, you'll be wandering around. Mark 6, verse 14 down. Let us see what the Bible is saying. Hallelujah. From 14. And the Pharisees also. Mark chapter 6. Hallelujah. From 14. And King Herod heard of him, for his name was spread abroad, and he said that John the Baptist was risen from the dead, and therefore mighty works do show forth themselves in him. Others said that is Elijah, and others said that is a prophet, or as one of the prophets. But when Herod heard thereof, he said, it is John whom I beheaded. You listen. It is John whom I beheaded. He's risen from the dead. For Herod himself set forth and laid hold upon John and bound him in prison for Herodias' sake, his brother Philip's wife. For he had married her. For John had said unto Herod, it is not lawful for thee to have thy brother's wife. Therefore, Herodias had a quarrel against him and would have killed him, but she could not. For Herod feared John, knowing that he was a just man and a holy and observed him. And when he heard him, he did many things and heard him gladly. And when a covenant day was come, that Herod on the birthday made a supper to his lost high captain and chief estate of Galilee. And when the daughter of the said Herodian came in and danced and pleased Herod, and then he sat with him. And the king said unto the damsel, ask of me whatsoever thou wilt, I will give it thee. And he swore unto her, whatsoever thou shalt ask of me, I will give thee unto the half of my kingdom. And she went forth and said to her mother, what shall I ask? And she said, the head of John the Baptist. And she came in straightway with haste into the king and asked, saying, I will that thou give me by and by in the change of head of John the Baptist. And the king was exceedingly sorrow. Yet for the old sake, and for the sake which sat with him, he would not reject her. And immediately the king sent an executioner and commanded his head to be brought. And he went and beheaded him in prison. And brought his head into the church and gave it to the damsel, and the damsel gave it to her mother. John did not struggle. His head was beheaded. John did not call fire. John did not call back to sender. John did not return back to anyone. His head was cut off in prison. When the Bible is saying, right from the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence, it means that John laid down his life for the kingdom's sake. He took it by force. It is not in violence. Die by thunder. No. We didn't see a place in the Bible where John dragged. Not at all. Hallelujah. Look at the message of John. Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. That is his message. An ass is laid upon a tree. That is his message. You need to repent, brethren. If you know, you must see Jesus. You must know who you are. You must possess the spirit of Jesus. If not, you can't see Jesus on that day. In the days of Noah, few people make it. Amen. In the days of Lot, few people make it. If Jesus shall come now, only few will make it. Because many are walking in ignorance. We need to drop our idea. What you have taught in theology, master's, diploma, whatever you have, what you need is the spirit of Jesus. Hallelujah. If the spirit of Christ that raised him from the dead lives in you, the same spirit will quicken, vitalize your mortal body. That spirit is what you need. Spirit of Jesus, spirit of meekness, spirit of forgiveness. Hallelujah. Spirit of serving God in spirit and in truth. Not spirit of anger. Not spirit of kill that people are doing today. No. May God deliver us from ignorance in the mighty name of Jesus. Going to heaven is not easy, beloved brethren. Here is where you will hear the undiluted word of God. Amen. If you have questions, you can ask. Amen. If you are ashamed to ask now, if I'm up the line, you can still ask. I will reply you. Stop living in ignorance. Hallelujah. Spiritual warfare is the topic we started. Spiritual warfare. I want to open our eyes for us to know who we are. Which spirit are you possessing? Are you still possessing the spirit of return back to sender? Die by fire, die by thunder, die by brimstone. Your pastor say 1, 2, 3, fire. That is not spirit of Jesus. You can't see that from Jesus' mouth. You can't see that from Apostle Paul's mouth. Neither Peter. Look at the scripture. May God have mercy. Hallelujah. In Matthew 11, from 12 to 15, the Bible says this was Elijah to come, which is John. John came with a different spirit, not to kill. Right from the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence. Violence. He was not in fighting. He was not in dragging. He allowed himself to be beheaded for the kingdom's sake. Violence taken by force. The violence there is not killing by sword. It's not returning by to the sender. No, it is not those that dig a pit fall into it. No. You are living in ignorance. Hallelujah. We are going to pray. Remember, here is the gathering of the heavenly candidates in true holiness and righteousness. Those who are ready to purify themselves. Those who are ready to forgive those who have offended them. Those who are ready to beg for forgiveness for those who you have offended, whether they are young or old, ask them to forgive you. Those who are ready to give back what does not belong to them. Those who are ready to make their restitution. As many as you have deceived, as many as you have cheated, you go back to them and amend your life, your ways with them. Otherwise, you will not see Jesus. Hallelujah. Going to heaven is not easy. Somebody die for it. Stop living in ignorance. Stop saying your pastor say, your bishop say, your apostle say. No, that is not the spirit of Jesus. Spirit of Jesus is different. The Son of Man has not come to take man's life. Glory be to God. Let us pray. Hallelujah. If no question this evening, we are going to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we have heard your word. Father, the entrance of your word gives us light. Let us obey your word. It is better to obey than sacrifice, O Lord. Give us the spirit of repentance. Let us possess the spirit of Jesus. Let us know who we are in Christ Jesus, O Lord. Open our spiritual eyes, O Lord God, that we will drop our pride and come back to you in holiness and righteousness. In spirit and in truth. so that we'll not miss heaven, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I pray for as men have listened to this message, let there be doers of your word, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus. As many that are ready to repent and forgive also those that they have offended. Jesus, is there anyone sick among them? I release your healing power upon their life now, right from their head to their toes. Be healed in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we bless your name. I cover myself, my wife, and children with the blood of Jesus. Every power that will fight the true word of God, I bind your powers and your precious. Be bound in heaven in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. If you have not yet received Jesus, say this after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I've heard your word tonight. I've come in repentance. Forgive my sins. Cancel my name from the book of death. Put my name in the book of life. Thank you because it is done. In Jesus' name. If you have done this, welcome to the body of Christ. You need a church where you'll be taught on how to live a life of holiness and righteousness, serving God in spirit and in truth. A church where you'll be taught how to do your restitution, forgiveness. Hallelujah. If you live in Europe, we are in the Republic of Ireland, you can worship with us every Monday. We have our fellowship from 5. Every Wednesday, also from 5. Every Sunday, by 12, we start our Sunday service. If you live in Nigeria, the address is on the screen. Our pastors, the one in Benin, the one at Abuja, call them. You'll be blessed in the name of Jesus. Those of you that live in Warri, we are coming to Warri. Life and Peace Ministry is coming to Warri. All people, all of you around Warri, Sapley, all around, we are coming. You are going to be blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. For those of you that listen to Edo language, I'll be online on Wednesday, 8 p.m. London time. Be with me and God will bless you. In Jesus' name. Amen.